fantastic to have you here tonight at the Children's BAFTAs. Are you looking forward to the evening?
I am indeed. This is something completely new for me, and it's lovely to have been invited. And yeah, the noise level already seems probably the most rock and roll thing I've been at for a long time.
Why do you think it's so important to celebrate achievements, particularly in children's programming?
You know what? To be really honest with you, I think a lot of the children's TV that's been made and has been made in the last, you know, 10 years, especially the British stuff, you know, like Your Horrible Histories, have really brought a new element to good TV, it being educational, music-based, you know, comedy-based, all these things together. And I think it's sort of pushed the boundaries and pushed television forward. So, yeah, I think there's a lot of stuff out there that's really great.
And when you were a little Sharleen, what shows did you watch growing up? What stayed with you?
For me, I loved Crystal Tips and Alistair, HR Puff and Stuff with Jack Wilde. What else I love? Custard the Cat, Rhubarb, loved Rhubarb. All those shows, Jack and Ori.
What's coming up for you at the moment? Are you working on any material at the moment?
There's a new album coming out in February for the 25th anniversary of Texas, and I go on tour on April.
What can we expect from that album?
We were in New York re-recording all the original hits. So it's a special, it's a big old box with lots of the originals, the new versions, 5 new tracks, so yeah.
And out of those new tracks, is there one that you're particularly proud of or excited for fans to hear?
Oh God, yeah. One of the new ones will be the first single, which you'll probably start hearing round about New Year.
And you mentioned you've been revisiting these classic songs. Are there any in particular that you're especially excited to get a chance to reimagine?
The ones that were more exciting were the ones that weren't particularly like, I mean, I love all of them, but certain ones you like more than others. So songs like When We Are Together, you know, some of them have turned out better than the originals, which I never really gave it much thought thinking we could do that. But to be honest, they've turned out way better than we ever imagined. It's completely changed, but you know, change is good. I think the music business at the moment is in a very sort of strange, difficult place. I wouldn't like to be a young musician trying to succeed or break into the music industry just now, because I think it's very closed in the roots that you've got to go down. But you know, that's life. I think the one great thing with social media and everything like that is the way that young people are making their own records, producing them, make their own videos, everything, and they're even putting them out there themselves, you know. So there's no labels, there's no middleman or anything. There's basically artists putting out their own music, so it's almost like a touch of punks coming back, and I hope that escalates greatly.
And my final question, do you have a message to fans, I guess particularly fans who can't wait to celebrate 20 years of Texas?
I look forward to seeing you on the Texas tour, hopefully.
Do we know when the tickets are going to be up for that one?
I'll be really honest with you, it's sold out.
Oh.
But there'll be more dates added for later in the year.
Fantastic. Well, we'll get on that. Thanks, Sean.